أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, يا الله سبحانه وتعالى أكسبت أور صلاة. الحمد لله وجزت فين صلاة الفجر يا جماعة. الحمد لله رب العالمين. It's good to start your day with ذكر الله with وضوء. When you stand before Allah سبحانه وتعالى and you make your صلوات, it's a good sign for you and for in general the Muslim Ummah. Good sign for you that you have a good start with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And also if you pray Salat al-Isha in Jama'ah, you have a good end. And what is in between, Allah will take care of you, inshallah. When you have a good start and a good end, that's good. Somebody asked me, Sheikh, you know, people will stay in their graves for years, hundreds of years. And the grave is so dark, what should we do? Subhanallah. And also, the time in the grave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stop the time for people because you are in different world. You are in the hereafter. The time there gonna stop. The one who died since Adam time and exactly he's the same will be the same time of the one who died before the day of judgment. The time is zero there. But anyway, القبر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said روضة من رياض الجنة أو حفرة من حفر النار. It's a garden of Jannah or piece of hell. والعياذ بالله. So that's why, how can you furnish your grave with too many good things, which is you have to prepare it from now, this dunya, subhanallah. People, they say, al-qabr mukhif. Al-qabr is not something good. Mukhif, it's dark. It's, subhanallah, different world, different condition. It is according to your iman and what you have from good deeds, this is exactly what you're gonna see there. But how can I have light and nur and jannah and I will be happy in my grave? This عالم البرزخ or another word in Arabic حياة البرزخ. حياة البرزخ means حياة means life. Means people they are living in their graves. It's a different life from here and different life from the hereafter too. It's called حياة البرزخ. The life of البرزخ. البرزخ means what is the grave. Subhanallah. But that's why people they are living in the way Allah knows about it. Subhanallah. But that's why يعني in these years where you are in your grave try to do something good. How? For example, what about if you make istighfar? That istighfar, when you go there, you're gonna see it. طوبة لمن وجد في صحيفته استغفارا كثيرا. طوبة forgiveness, المغفرة. For those who find in their record a lot of istighfar. استغفر الله واتوب إليه. استغفر الله واتوب إليه. Just for example, subhanAllah, that will lighten your grave. SubhanAllah. Really, it is serious matter. It is not, subhanAllah, a joke. What about if you say, I have a mission in this dunya. Before I die, I'm going to make, وليكن, for example, 300 ختمة of Quran. I'm going to make ختمة of the Quran 300 times or 400 times or 1,000 times in my life. Means try every month to make one ختمة or two ختمة. In Ramadan, people, they're killing me, Sheikh, we'll make 10 ختمة. See, try to recite the Quran as much as you can. That will lighten your grave. More you stuck with the Holy Quran. I'm just giving example, subhanAllah. Each rak'ah unit, or rak'ah you are doing it in the salah, that gonna be rasid. You're saving something for you, for your future there in the grave. SubhanAllah, gonna be nur, light for you. Salatu nur. Like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. That's why very important. Any zikr, any hawqala, when you say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, and you repeat it. Any dhikr, astaghfirullah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, huh? Subhanallah, subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayhi. Any kind of dhikr that will benefit you there. Al-Quran al-Karim and its recitation. At-tashahud in the salah and saying ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. What about the sadaqah, the best of your good deeds? Even the ayah in the Quran said, if those who are in the grave, they're going to have a chance to come back to this dunya, they will come to make sadaqah and to go back. Allah said, لَا صَدَّقَنَّ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. I want to go back to this dunya to make sadaqah, charity, and to be one of those who are righteous people. SubhanAllah. That's why all of this, it's a rasid. Saving. CD for you there. Rasid. Ah, SubhanAllah. So very important to furnish your grave with this kind of good deeds, it will lighten your grave. According to the hadith of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When you will be in the grave and people are staying outside, they did not even leave your, subhanAllah, your burial after they buried you, after they buried. The two angels, المنكر والنكير, they will sit you in the grave. In the grave. And they will ask you three questions. من ربك? Who is your Lord? وما دينك? What's your religion? And who is your prophet? Your Nabi, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. During that time, these two angels, they are very harsh. And they are treating everybody in very bad way. Even the Muslims. They are أزرقان أسودان يخطان في الأرض معهما مرزبة. They have hammer and they are. I read too many hadith about them. Authentic hadith. And they, Rasul Hashem called them فتنة القلب. The trial of the grave. They're gonna be harsh with everybody, even the mu'min. But the good thing about the mu'min, they will try to come from his leg side or his foot. The Quran will be there and the Salah. Salah will be there and the Quran will be close to his head and around his him. Right and left, you say sadaqa, jihad, zikr, salah, hawqala, all of these good deeds will surround him like shield, they're gonna shield him for protection. They try to come him from this side. No, no, no. You're not allowed to come from this side. His a'mal, his good deeds in the grave. You're not to come, you're not allowed. Al Quran, you're not allowed. Al salah, you're not allowed. Go away from here. Don't touch him. Subhanallah, your a'mal will defend you. That's why it's very important how to furnish your grave. With this light, with these good deeds, with zikr, ibadah, amal saliha, all of this, it will light in your grave. Especially salah. Rasulullah said it clearly. Was salatu nur. Light upon light. Salah is nur, light for you. Especially in the grave while you are alone, nobody with you, your family will leave you. Subhanallah, and they're gonna go back to distribute your money, and might be your wife, she's gonna marry, and your kids, Allah, they're gonna remember you or not. Allahu a'lam. For that's why the only thing will benefit you, your good deeds. Wallahi al-azim, nobody gonna benefit you. Don't give me my money. No, you're gonna leave everything. Even the checks and the like the Jewish lady, her husband was very smart. And what did he say? He said in his will, I need all of my properties, my money to come with me in my grave. He hates her. I don't like, and he did not like any money from him to go to her after his death. And then his wife, she was in a big trouble. How can I give this stupid man my money? He died already. I need this money after his death. Yes, she's looking to her benefit. And her friend was Jewish, smart. She told her, you know, write a check for him and put it in his coffin. Give him a check. That's why, see, that's it. There is nobody, no check, no. You don't have cellular phone to talk to somebody. Please give me help. No. خلاص. You will be cut off from the dunya except what Rasulullah said. صدقة جارية ولد صالح يدعو لك أو علم ينتفع به أو من ورث مصحفا ومن كرى نهرا ومن حفر بئرا ومن ملا بيتا لابن السبيل ومن ترك ولد صالح. Anyway, all of these good deeds, if you make it, their reward, it will be credit for you in your grave. That's why my advice, make your grave as a bank for you. That bank of your good deeds, your currency. Yeah, make more currency, good deeds as much as you can. Zikr, ibadah, istighfar, salah, tasbih, all of these, sadaqat, subhanallah. And take care of your ibadah very, very much, very important. Subhanallah. This is my advice today, like what Dr. Wim said yesterday, the five pillars of Islam. And he said, laysa al-birra an tuwallu wujuhakum. You have to furnish your house. Put the foundation, the basic, and put the pillars and fix your house and furnish it with good deeds. There is no limit for it. Sheikh Nabilsi, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him more health, he said, وَأَعْمَالُ الْخَيْرِ كَعَدَدِ أَنْفَاسِ الْخَلَائِقِ. There is no limit for making good deeds. Can you count the breath of people when they breathe, all the creatures of Allah? You cannot. فَعَمَلُ الْخَيْرِ, there is no limit for عَمَلُ الْخَيْرِ, making good deeds. There is no limit. كَعَدَدِ أَنْفَاسِ الْخَلَائِقِ. For that's why very important, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabb al-Alameen, to give us husn al-khatima, good end, and to make us firm in our deen until we meet him. Amen, ya Rabb al-Alameen. Rabbana taqabbal minna, waghfir lana, warhamna, wasturna, wajburna, wa anil quburana, wa qubur al-muslimin. Ya Rabb al-Alameen, wa thabbitna ala al-huda, wa ala tariq al-mustaqim. Allahumma ya Rabb al-Alameen, la tumitna illa wa anta radin anna, ya Rabb. Amidna muslimin, ya Rahman, rahimin, wa alhiqna bis-salihin, ya Rabb al-Alameen. واغفر لنا ولأبائنا ولأمتنا كما ربينا صغيرا واغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم الأموات لك يا رب سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات احفظنا جميعا بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمالنا وجعلنا لك يا ربنا من الشاكرين وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خير. جزاك الله خير. نعم أسمع.